Hey guys, and welcome back. This week we are going to be analyzing Judicial Services exam and what can you do to clear these exams ASAP. For today's video, we will take the example of Delhi Judicial Services 2011 mains result. You can pick up the result of any state you are interested in and corroborate these findings or use the analytical tips from this video to draw your own analysis. But because DJS is the most commonly taken exam by most candidates and we get a lot of questions about it, we will use that as the common denominator for analysis. The point of this video is to understand the beast that the Judicial Services exam is. And if you know your enemy well, you know how to play your strengths. So we will try and understand, analyze the Judicial Services exam and see what you can do to clear them ASAP. So without any further delay, let's just get into the video. Number 1. Correlation between mains marks, that is marks obtained in the mains Judicial Services exam, and marks obtained in the interview. And what we're trying to show you here is that mostly everyone who has high ranks in the mains get high ranks in the interview. Means those who have higher ranks in the mains, who have better marks in the mains, get high marks in the interview. So here is a result of the 2011 Delhi Judicial Services mains. This is a public document and anyone can access it. Here you can see that everyone who has high marks in the mains got high marks in the interview as well. Now, we are not saying that you have to get marks between 460 and 520 or 470 and 530. That's not the point. Don't look at the marks, just look at the relativity and the correlation. Because marks and cutoffs vary from year to year. In one year, the highest marks is going to be 520. In the other year, the highest marks is going to be 420. That depends upon the examiners. That we're not looking at, but we're showing you the correlation that people who do well in the mains, who are higher ranks in the mains results, also get good marks in the interview. So if you work hard and get in the top 10, 15 ranks in the mains result, there is a high probability that the interview panel will give you good marks in the interview as well. Of course, there are always exceptions where people get high marks in the mains, but sometimes their interview does not go well and they don't get such high marks in the interview. And also there are exceptions the other way around where people don't get very high marks in the mains, but with their personality, they dazzle the interview board and they get very high marks in the interview, taking their overall score high, and hence they make the cutoff and they become a judge. But those are exceptions. The rule is that if you get good marks in the mains and you're in the top ranks in the mains results, there is a very high chance that the interview panel will give you high marks in the interview as well. You can see here another chart. This is the interview marks for the top 50 ranks in Delhi mains. That the top 50 ranks in Delhi mains did fairly well in the interview. One of them got a very high interview marks, that is 140, but most of them fared anywhere between 80 and 120 marks in the interview. So 8 people had 120 marks, 13 people had 110 marks, 11 had 100, 8 had 90, and 5 had 80. And then one person had 70. So you can see that those who were in the top 50 in the mains exam in Delhi Judicial Services 2010 also got fairly good marks, the higher range of marks in the interview as well. And now take a look at this chart. This is the chart for the ranks 50 to 100 in the DJS mains 2010. Before this, we looked at 1 to 50 in DJS mains and all of them had high interview marks. Now we're looking at those who got ranked 50 to 100 in the mains result. How did they do in the interview? Now you can see here that very few people got high interview marks. 110, 120, 130. Just one person each got 110 and 130. All of them lay between 70 and 100. So you can see from this that if you have high marks in the mains, there are high chances you get high marks in the interview, which makes sense because judges or the interview panel use it as a sort of filter system that if you have high marks in the mains, chances are that you're intelligent. So let's just give this person better marks in the interview. Of course, there are exceptions, but that is usually the filter system, and there is a high correlation and probability that you do good in the mains, you're good to go in the interview. As long as you know the basics and you do the interview well, you should sail right through. Now, to further drive in this point, let's just take a look at two more charts. Over here is a chart which shows the mains marks and the interview marks. And you can see that everybody between 490 and 510 had pretty high interview marks, and it is almost corresponding and there is a correlation. There are of course a couple of exceptions. There's someone who got 501.5 and they had very high marks in the interview, which is 132. But apart from it, it almost corresponds to your interview marks. And this is the last chart. This is again shows the mains written marks at the bottom and interview marks on the left side. So you can see mains marks 490, 492, 493, 500, 508, 509, 510. So everybody who got mains marks between 491 to 510 had their interview marks between 119 and 139. This is for the 2010 Delhi mains. And this is a chart. So you can see that everybody who had high marks in the mains got between 119 and 139 in the interview. Again, drives home the point that there is a good correlation between the two. Now that we've understood that the moral of this is that you work hard in the mains, you get a good rank, and then it is almost certain that you will get good interview marks and you will sail through unless there is some major problem. In higher chances, you get good marks in mains, you're through the interview. So mains is where the litmus test is. Now you may ask, fine, we get it. We have to do really well in the mains, but how do we do that? What do we do to achieve success in mains? Of course, you need to do your law subjects really well, and we have a lot of videos on that. In addition to doing the law, you need to also develop and hone your skill set to differentiate yourself from others. So here's the three-pronged strategy. You have to do your law subjects well, you have to hone your skill set, and the third one, strategy, is one I'm going to be discussing further in the video, so keep waiting for that. But these are the first two points let's discuss. Law subjects, you have to do well, you'll just have to study, there is no way around it. And we have a lot of law videos. Now, how do you develop these skill sets? So, answer writing, strategies to give you an edge over others, correct formats for answer writing, order writing, judgment writing, knowing strategies for essays, anything that gives you an edge over others which others won't have, is something that will develop your skill set. And I won't go into all of these here. I won't go into the details of how you can write answers or judgments or how you can get strategies, because we have a foundation course for judicial services exam which is jam-packed. We have given you all the strategies for PTs, mains, interview that you're going to need. We've given you answer writing formats, essay writing formats, tips, tricks, strategies, book recommendations, interview strategies. The foundation course is jam-packed with all of these, so I will not discuss those in detail here. If you want to know those, just get the foundation course. I will leave the link in the description box and you can get it on our online InstaMojo store. So, doing your law subjects well, and then honing your skill set for which you can use the foundation course are two important gateways to do really well in the mains judicial services exam. The third strategy is language and GK. This is the strategy that I was telling you about that I'm going to discuss. Now let's get to that. That's the third strategy. To do really well in the mains, in addition to know your law well, in addition to honing your skill set, you have to be good at language and GK. I cannot stress this enough. The reason for that is that it's possible to score much higher in language and GK papers. These are very scoring subjects, and it all depends entirely on your preparation and your capability. The marks in the law papers for everyone is somewhat in a similar range. People don't, very few outliers in mains papers for law subjects. Everyone gets around the same marks. That is fair because everybody knows the same law. Everybody studies from the same books. Everybody knows the same case laws. You can differentiate yourself by writing good answers, by following the correct formats. And yes, that will definitely give you an edge over others. And language and GK are also very important. Let's take a look at rank 1 to 10 of the DJS mains 2011. Now, these people got rank 1 to 10 in the final result. And the final result just has a column for total in the mains and total in the interview. They will not give you the breakup of mains. So what we have done is that we've taken out their mains result. That's when the mains result came out. We took out the people who finally became rank 1 to 10 in the final result. And we have taken out their mains marks. So the breakup of each subject. And that you can see on your screen right now. So let's take a look at criminal law. 117, 110, 104, 111, 120, 124, 24, 112, 106, 114. Very close by. So it's mostly between 106 to 124. Not too much variation. Everybody gets very similar marks. So in the law papers, there is so much that you can do to differentiate yourself. But in language and GK papers, you can see that people have gotten 141, 136, 150. If your GK and your language skills are good, you can get anywhere up till as high as 150 or 160 also. Because these papers are very scoring. Most of them are objective, apart from couple of questions like essays and short notes. So if you know GK and English and Hindi well, these are very scoring subjects. And over here, you can really get high marks. Now, you may ask, what will happen if we get high marks in language and GK paper? How will that help us? It'll help you in two ways. If you get high marks in language and GK paper, you can easily get your total marks in the mains to a higher range, which means that you get a higher rank in the mains. So when you go in the interview, they will see that you had very high marks in the mains. And language and GK, they're very scoring. They will take your total to a very higher number. So they will see that, okay, this person did very good in mains. That means this person is smart. So there is a correlation that you will get higher marks in the interview as well. So it takes your total high. And this is some place where you can really strike out language and GK. And secondly, high marks in language and GK also serve as a cushion. So let's say in one of the papers, criminal law or civil law one, your paper did not go so well. So there are chances that you will not be above the cutoff. In that case, if let's say you have 150 in language and GK out of 200, then your total still remains high. So it's like a cushion that even if one of your law papers don't go so well, your total marks will not suffer. You have to, of course, get the minimum percentage of marks required for each paper. But even if you have that minimum percentage of marks, if your law and GK marks are high, it'll give you the cushion that in case the law paper does not go well, your total will not suffer. You will still make the cutoff to go into the interview. Now, obvious question, how to do Hindi, English, GK? We get it now. We have seen that mains is very important. High marks in mains, the high correlation that you will get high marks in interview. How to get high marks in mains? Do law well. Do all the skill sets well. Hone your skill set. And give enough importance to language and GK papers. Don't just treat them as, okay, fine, we'll just do them later. No big deal. This is what will make or break your exam. Now you may ask that how to do Hindi, English, GK. We have so many videos on it. I will link the entire playlist on your screen. We have books for Hindi, English and GK. In GK book, we have used patching and images extensively. In English book, we have an exhaustive list of words which are all patched up by homonyms, synonyms, antonyms. All of those related words are patched up. And in addition to that, our English book also has idioms and legal phrases, again, patched up. If you don't know what patching is or how our books are, you can check out in the playlist that I linked on your screen. We have a lot of videos on it. And in the Hindi book, we have an exhaustive list of words. all of which are again related, they're patched up, their homonyms, synonyms, all of them are patched up. And if you do that, there is no chance that there will be a translation word that you don't know. There will be a word meaning that you don't know. And because you know all these words, it will create your vocabulary, which you can use in essays, you can use in short notes, you can use in word meanings and translation. Because if you have to write anything, you have to have a strong foundation. You have to know all the words. You will not find grammar on Hindi in our books or muhavre. But for Hindi and English, we have a master word list in our books. If you've been following our channel for a while now, you know how these books were created. Because a lot of you requested that we should batch up words for you because you love the batching technique videos. So we sat down, we took every past year paper, we took out every word and we patched it up and we created these books for Hindi, English and GK, especially Hindi. That is a master word list. The same goes for English. It'll serve as a foundation for your language skills. If you're looking for translation, which is 60 marks in Delhi Judicial Services and there's translation in UP, Haryana, look no beyond ASAP Laws Hindi book. Yes, it will not have muhavare. It will not have essays, but this will create your foundation. It'll give you all the words that you need to know. You can use those words in translation. There is not going to be a single word when it comes to translation which is not there in the ASAP Law Hindi book, and we openly challenge you because we spent so much time and effort patching up more than 5,000 words for these books. And you know the origin story. And all of you were lovely. All of you send us nice reviews and comments and how much you love. There are always people who will say, but it does not have muhavare for Hindi. Or there are no essays in the Hindi book. That was not the purpose of our book. The purpose of our book is to serve as a foundation for your language skills, to expand your vocabulary. There is no word that will be out of your vocabulary once you finish the books. And there is nothing on the internet which is comparable to our books, and it will give you an exhaustive word list all batched up. So please take a moment to take into account the work we have put in and its intended purpose. I hope this analysis gives you some clarity on judicial services exam and how you can clear them ASAP. All the best, get to work, and we will see you soon.